Okay guys, so I'm gonna moisturize my face and I'm gonna be using coconut oil to do that. And I have coconut oil in this little container. I'm gonna be using a foundation brush to apply it. Okay guys, so I know I look like a total grease ball right now. That's because of the coconut oil. I noticed that with the coconut oil, my face isn't as dry than when I usually do any other moisturizer. So the coconut oil, I feel like it works best. So now I'm going to be priming my face using this Sensation Primer. You guys probably can't see it. I don't know the brand. I got it for my makeup kit and I'm gonna use it. So I'm gonna put it in the back of my hand and just put it all over my face. So I'm gonna be catching you guys up with like life right now because I never get to talk to you guys and I've been told that I should talk more in my videos because I don't really. Yeah, I'll probably be a little bit weird this video because I never usually do this. Okay, so I already applied my primer. I'm gonna be applying my GRWM foundation, and this is a cream foundation and it comes with a variety of different shades. And I know a lot of people don't want to buy all these shades because they just want to use them for themselves. So I know that GRWM does sell them in a little I think in separate containers, but they also have another one that's just 5 different shades, so you could just use them for like highlight and concealer and then foundation. Up to you guys. Okay guys, so something new in my life right now is I recently got a piercing, and technically it's 2 piercings. I got my industrial. Okay, so it is my 4th day with this piercing, and it still kind of hurts. Only when I touch it though. Like right now it's not really hurting. Okay, so I got my industrial piercing on Valentine's Day. And I was planning on getting it the next day, but I just wanted to get it over with and just do it. So I got it on Valentine's Day. So when I walked in to get my piercing, they made me sign some papers. So, he sat me down in the chair, which I kind of wanted a bed because I seen in a lot of videos of other people getting their industrial that they were laying down. And so I thought like I'd feel less like worried, you know, what if I fall or something? I don't know. Anyways, so I didn't say anything. I was just like, okay, whatever, I'll just sit down, you know, he knows what he's doing. And he was kind of getting straight to it, and I was kind of like nervous because I had never gotten obviously an industrial piercing, so like it was my cartilage and he was making it seem like nothing. Obviously to him it's nothing, he probably does that every day, but to me it was like it was huge. I wanted him to explain more than he did. But he just placed the dots, and he didn't even ask me where, like, if the placement was good for me or anything. So I was like, can I go look in the mirror? And then he's like, sure. But I was basically like just trying to like, oh my god, this is it, I'm gonna be doing it. Like, not because like, I mean obviously I cared where it's at, but like I trusted that he knew where he was putting it. But just because I was so nervous. Okay, so anyways, on to the pain. The first hole he did was this one, and that one honestly, like, it didn't hurt as bad. Like, I was kind of like, that was it. Like, I felt like it was gonna be worse, but it wasn't bad at all. Like, it felt like if I got in one of my earlobe piercings, it just burned afterwards, but that was it. Not bad at all. The second one, the one up here, oh, that one hurt so bad. It felt like a lot of pressure. But not too bad either, you know, like, I'm pretty sure anybody can take it.
What really hurt, I think, was, when he was trying to, like, remove the needle and put in the piercing. Oh, that really hurt, like, on both, ends. It was quite painful, but, like I said, it doesn't last very long. It's literally just a few second pain.
After pain was not that bad. What did hurt was when I went outside, and it was a windy day, let me tell you. The wind was going everywhere and it was moving my piercing. Not my piercing, but like, you know, the wind is like going everywhere. And it felt so bad. Oh my goodness. Like, So as long as you're not outdoors on a winning day, like,
and you'll be fine. I can touch it already. It still feels more bruised around that area, and it's still kind of swollen and red. But what could I do? You know, it doesn't hurt all day, so I'm using a cosmetic sponge to blend out the creases and then set it with the powder. Sorry guys, it's a little bit difficult to set my under eyes while talking, but they're done. Now I'm just gonna dust off the powder. I didn't wait at all, like a long time. I literally just set it just so the creases are nice and set.
I really like to set my powder, but not for a long time, because then that dries me out.
Even if I'm oily, I don't do that. I feel like it's very drying. I used to do that a lot, but I realized it dries out my skin so bad and it just looks cakey and I don't like it. So I just leave it on like for like a second, meanwhile I'm doing the other eye, and then I dust it off right away, real quick.
Okay guys, so now I'm going to contour using my Kat Von D Shade and Light palette, and I actually won this one in a giveaway. I already had one of my own, but I had hit pan, and a friend of mine was doing a giveaway on her YouTube channel. She's actually in my makeup class, and we subscribe to her channels, and she's really awesome. It's pretty cool of her to, like, you know, have a giveaway so soon in her channel. Check her out, guys. Her link is in my description below. So yeah, I'm gonna be using the middle shade right here and a little bit of this darker one just to define the contour. I'm using this brush. It's a no brand. I got it off of Amazon. I got a whole set for $16, so. Okay, I'm gonna be using this fan brush and the same middle shade, and I'm gonna be putting it in my forehead. I kind of like this fan brush for that, because I feel like any other brush would kind of like mess up my hair a little bit, and this one kind of like has the angle, you know. Okay, so I'm going to be grabbing a minier version of that fan brush to define the contour using the darkest contouring shade on the palette. I'm kind of going in with the more darker shade, and I'm going to be contouring a little bit more of the forehead near their hairline. Okay, so I'm going to be applying my Milani blush in Tea Rose. I'm going to be using a brush like this. So besides the piercing, anything else that's new is the events I've been going to for my makeup class. It's really awesome. They've been sending me to cool places. I'm gonna be using MAC Soft and Gentle. It's such a beautiful color. I love this. This is probably like one of the best highlighters there is, because you can like make it look so natural but yet so popping, you know. Like, I love this. So I'm gonna be putting my MAC Prep and Prime and spraying it onto the brush. So that time for the brows. So I'm gonna be using my Anastasia brow gel pomade in dark brown. I'm gonna just use this to draw the lines and fill it in a little bit, and then
first,
I'm gonna
gotta brush these little hairs because they go crazy. So I like to start off my brows with the front by tracing it, not all the way in the front, just a little bit, like right here, but right there. So I'm not gonna make a straight line, I'm gonna go in little strokes. Okay, so now for the top, I'm gonna start kind of over here, not all the way in the front. Same thing, just strokes. Okay, so now I'm gonna fill it in, starting from the back. Once I'm close to the front, I'm just going to grab the spoolie and brush it up. I'm brushing upwards, but kind of like combing them where they already are placed. So what I do to get the kind of faded look is I still use a spoolie and I kind of clean it off. So I'm going to be using a towel to clean it off. You know, take off all the excess product that's on there, because if you have too much product on there, it's just gonna make everything look the same color, and do circular motions. Don't worry if you get messy. We'll like fix that later. I'm gonna be grabbing a thicker eyebrow brush because I wanna fill in all my like bald spots, because I have a lot, as you guys can't tell. I can't find my thicker one, so I'm just gonna use this one. This one was the MAC one, and it's really thin, and I love it and everything, but... Oh, I found it. Okay, so this one is Mikasa Beauty. This is, like, a perfect eyebrow brush to, like, fill in everything. It's not as thin as the MAC one, but I love it. If you guys are interested, I'll leave my coupon code in the description below. And you guys get 15% off any brushes or any of their products on their website. So I'm gonna be using their Modern Renaissance palette by Anastasia. And I'm gonna be using color Cypress Umber for the bald spot. I'm gonna pick up a little bit because this palette is super pigmented. And I'm just gonna fill it in just very lightly. And I brushed them before, so then I know where I need to put some product. So, yeah, that's what I'm doing. Just a little bit. And then I'm gonna keep grabbing my spoolie and brushing it. So I'm gonna fill in kind of right there. It doesn't matter if you get messy, girl. Don't be afraid. And brushing it off. Here is where the magic happens. You're gonna be grabbing some of your concealer, foundation, whatever. Either works fine. Even eyeshadow primer. So I'm gonna be grabbing some in a thin brush like this. It's a flat top. This one, it is from Bedellium. And you can buy these at Nigel's, but if not, if you find a similar one from any other brand, feel free to get that one. This one's just the one I have. I'm pretty sure a lot of brands have the same brush, and it probably works just as fine. I'm gonna be grabbing an angled brush like this one, and I'm gonna just blend out that concealer. Okay, I'm gonna be grabbing this brush and just blending it out. Okay guys, so that's how you get your faded brow. I actually didn't set it with powder, so I'm gonna be doing that right now. I'm gonna be grabbing some that's on my cap, dusting off the excess. Did you see that? Yeah, because if not, that would have happened to your whole face. I know it looks really dramatic right now, but that's probably because I don't have anything else on my face besides that brow. So once I do the eyeshadow, I notice it doesn't look as dramatic.
I'm gonna go ahead and do the other brow, and I'll be right back.
Alright guys, so I just finished the brows. Now I'm gonna start with the eyes. First gonna prime them. I'm gonna be using MAC Soft Ochre. And I love this thing. It really does make your eyeshadow last, girl. You need to get yourself one of these if you're wearing eyeshadow.
I'm gonna play with my fingers because I don't know. I feel like it works best when I do it with my fingers.
I never used to use primer, but honestly, if you want your eyeshadow to last, you have to, like you really do. Unless you just want to use concealer. Honestly, concealer works good. I always do that whenever I'm lazy. But if you're gonna go out and you're gonna need your eyeshadow to last, you have to use a good primer. And this one is really good. The only thing I have to say, it's really drying. That's what I like to do with my finger. I feel like it warms it up, so it kind of like blends a little bit better. Okay, so I'm gonna be using this brush, and it has already some powder in there. I'm gonna blend out the primer until I have no creases at all. You don't want to set creases, you want to set no creases. Okay, and then I'm gonna put it on top, set it really good, so then the eyeshadows could just glide on. So I'm grabbing more powder and setting it. So once again, I'm gonna be using my Modern Renaissance palette, and I'm gonna be using Burnt Orange as a transition color. So I'm picking up this blending brush and grabbing some of the color, tapping off the excess, and just putting it a little bit above the crease and on the crease. Even if you can't see it, like slowly build it up. Don't get impatient. I'm gonna actually be grabbing tape and putting it at the ends of my eyes so I can do the look I did on my Instagram recently.
A little bit crazy, but it'll leave your eyeshadow looking so good.
So, same thing. Same color, just redoing it. It's gonna give you that like cut look right here, and I love that look. And honestly, you don't have to use the tape, but I like to use it. You could always go ahead and clean it up afterwards with concealer. Okay, I'm gonna be grabbing my Lorac Unsipped palette, and I'm gonna be grabbing Unspoken using my MAC 216, I believe, 217 brush. This is a popular one that they have. Slowly tapping it in. I've learned so many times not to just go in with like a whole bunch, because oh my goodness, I'll probably do like what not to do, like video for makeup, like mistakes that I've done that I've learned throughout time. Okay, so I removed the tape because I kind of already got the line that I wanted. We're not done with the eyeshadow yet. And the tape kind of removes some makeup, so you could just go in with some translucent powder. or your setting powder.
Okay, so I'm gonna be grabbing Cypress Umber using the Morphe R34. Just a little bit. Tap off the excess and putting it in the outer corner. You're gonna bring it inward. Not upward, just inward. Kind of get that ombre effect. So I'm gonna be going back in with the MAC brush, and I'm kind of gonna blend these two colors together. Just like that. You want that nice gradient effect. You know, I'm gonna be grabbing a clean brush and blending them all in together. I'm gonna be using this gold color. It's called Primavera, I believe. I don't know if you can see it. I love this color. It's really pigmented. So I'm just gonna be grabbing any flat surface and grabbing my Fix Plus and spraying some on here. Just so we have a little bit on there. And I'm gonna be grabbing an angled brush and just dipping it on there. Just so it's a little bit wet. And I'm gonna be putting into the gold eyeshadow. So to blend it, I'm gonna be using my finger and kind of like tapping it on top. So I'm gonna do the other eye and I'll be right
back. Okay guys, so I forgot to film, but I did my tear ducts and my brow bone using Vermeer, I think, from the Modern Renaissance palettes, and it's a really good highlight shade. So now I want to go ahead and line my eyes using an e.l.f. liquid liner. So I'm gonna be using this one. Okay guys, so the eyeliner is done, and that's not how I'm leaving it. I'm gonna actually set it with this brown right here, the one I've been using for like this eyebrow brush, and dip some into the shadow and just set it so I gonna clean the liner using the same brush I used to carve them out and some concealer. This angled brush, and I'm gonna blend out the concealer. Grab some powder and set it. Gonna be lining the top waterline. I don't know what it's called. Basically tight lining my eyes. So oh my god, I used to do I used to do this with no problem. Like, I was a pro at this, and now I'm so scared. Okay, that should be good. I used to think this feels so good, and I mean,
mean, it doesn't feel bad, but I was a weirdo. Okay, so I'm gonna do the same with the bottom. I'm gonna kind of like not connect it, but like up to here maybe. Like that. Okay, now I'm going to be grabbing a thinner brush like this one, and I'm gonna smudge it. I'm sorry guys, I'm flipping you guys off. I'm gonna be grabbing burnt orange and a little bit of this one to put it under the eyes. Okay, so I'm gonna curl my lashes using my Forever 21 eyelash curler, and this is my favorite eyelash curler. The Forever 21 ones are so good. I'm gonna be putting some mascara. I'm using the Maybelline Colossal Spider Effect, but not the brush because the brush will leave them so spidery looking. I just want. Okay, so I'm going to be using my Ardell Demi Wispies, and they're not in the packaging because I've already used them once. So I forgot where I left my glue, but I recently purchased this one from the Daisol. I heard a lot of good reviews about it from my makeup teacher, so I'm going to try it out today. It just looks like this. It just says eyelash glue. Yeah. So hopefully it works good. Whoa, that was a lot. Okay. I am so impressed with this eyelash glue. Like, honestly, like, I'd never felt an eyelash so stuck to my eye. Feels like it's never gonna come off, which is a good thing. Okay. Hey guys, so all that's left is bottom mascara. That is gonna be really easy, and then your lips, and then I think I'm gonna touch up my contour one more time. Okay guys, so for lips, I'm going to be using the Maybelline Color Jolt, and this is in Stripped Down, and it is number 5. So, I'm just gonna apply it to my lips. I like to apply it first and then apply my liner, so then, I don't know, the liner kind of fixes it. Using the Nabi Mauve lip liner. Mauve, my favorite color. Okay, so I want to add a little bit of more gloss to my lips, so I'm going to be using this one right over here. It is a Shine Shot, and it is also by Maybelline. So I'm going to put it on a flat surface and just use a lip brush to apply it, so then I don't like contaminate the rest of the lip gloss and put some pinks in there. You know, you don't want to do that. So okay guys, so that's it for my video. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed.